Hello, good morning my dear students. Welcome back once again. Hoping you all are absolutely well. So today we will start wave optics, and under this topic we are going to discuss about, first of all, what is wave, then wave nature or wave theory of light, and wave front. So first of all, what is wave? Now, if we ask what do you see wave, immediately with this question one thing arises in our mind, that is something which we see on water bodies like pond, river or sea. But in case of water bodies in our daily life, the wave, that is like pond, wave cannot be created automatically. If we throw stone on a wastewater surface, only in that case the disturbance or agitation which is created is called wave. But in river or sea, wave is generally created automatically. You don't need to see the stone, it is generally created due to high tide, isn't it? So wave means that is any disturbance or agitation which is produced in any medium, isn't it? Just like in water. Simple example of wave is generally a disturbance or agitation which we see on rest water surface like pond. So what happens when, if we throw a stone on rest water bodies, then exactly at the point of striking, that is at the center of the agitation, okay, the water bodies are generally an agitation or disturbance is created, and then immediately it spreads in all directions with a particular velocity. It's called wave. Now the fact is that in this case, the one interesting thing to be noticed, that in this case the water particles doesn't change their position, doesn't propagate. The agitation which is created, it is generally propagates, okay, in all directions, but the water particles doesn't move in forward direction. They only just vibrate about that mean position, that is ups and downs, which is the reason when the creation of the wave. Okay. Now, how this agitation, this is nothing but so it is the matter of transmission of energy, isn't it? That's the vibration energy. When stone is thrown, isn't it? Mechanical energy. So the water molecule started to vibrate. Then in this case, the energy is transmitted from one particle to the next particle. We may call this is just this transmitter like a coronavirus, just like that, becomes infectious. When the first particle generally vibrates, it acquires kinetic energy because it acquires velocity. So according to the velocity, it generally acquires kinetic energy, then it vibrates, and then this vibration becomes infectious, contagious, like nothing but COVID-19 virus, we can say. So from particle to particle successively, so the first particle vibrates, then it transfers the vibration and energy to the next particle, then to next particle, the next particle. In this way this energy is transmitted. So we can say this is just like, okay, the vibrational energy, or the energy which is created due to vibration, is generally transmitted to the successive particles, water molecules or water particles like coronavirus, and due to this energy the wave is generally transmitted or propagates in all directions. Water molecules doesn't move, isn't it? Doesn't change their position, or you can say doesn't propagate in the forward direction. Clear? They only move about their mean position, ups and downs. Clear? So this is called wave in our, from our daily life. But this wave is generally called the mechanical wave. Okay, this is called transverse wave, or the mechanical wave, or the elastic wave, since it is produced due to mechanical energy. And elastic wave means each and every particle is generally restored or returns back to its original position, just like elasticity. Okay, so this is called mechanical wave, and it needs a medium for propagation. But when any wave is created on rest water body surface, it looks like this, isn't it? That is peak and down, isn't it? Maximum displacement, minimum displacement. This is called crest, we all know. That is the particle having maximum amplitude from its mean position is called created. And the negative maximum, it is called trough, we all know that. Clear? So this is mechanical wave which is created on the wave. So we can say wave doesn't create automatically. So what is the concept of wave? It means the amplitude, it means from zero to maximum, then zero, negative maximum, or you can say the minimum, isn't it? So minimum, maximum, minimum, negative maximum, then again minimum, isn't it? Then again maximum, then minimum, negative maximum. So this is the concept of wave. Okay. 0 maximum, 0 negative maximum, clear? Then again 0 maximum, again 0 negative maximum. This is the concept of wave in case of any particle. This is in case of wave, which we can say, but in case of sound wave, there are so many waves, sound wave, light wave, sound is also, that is, where there is any vibration or any wave, there is also the amplitude, frequency, all these terms are related. So obviously in case of sound wave, there is also crest and trough, but these are not visible, isn't it? But when amplitude is maximum, loud sound is heard, when amplitude is minimum, faint sound is heard. We have already learnt in class 10. So this is the plain concept of wave, okay, the vibration, amplitude, maximum, zero, minimum, negative maximum, all this. And but unlike the waves created in, okay, in case of sound, in sound is wave, is a longitudinal wave, whereas the wave produced in the water is transversal. Particles moves in upward direction, up and down, and the wave is moved in the forward direction. So what is the angle? 90 degree. So that's why it is called transversal. But what about the light? Look at the angle. What is this 90 degree? This transversal. But what is light? Now we have learned about that, grown up, learning light is also a wave. Visible light is wave, which is nothing but the electromagnetic wave. It is electromagnetic wave. It means both electric and magnetic field are associated with light. It means both electric and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, then light moves in this direction. Light is an electromagnetic wave. These are nothing but x, y and z axis. We can write x, y and z axis. Why will you get at the corner of the home or house of any room? All three lines, x, y and z, you can see in any room. You can see, just see at the corner, okay, then you will get the three dimensional. So light is such a wave. Light is an electromagnetic wave. It means it is a kind of wave which contains both electric and magnetic field, and all are perpendicular, mutually perpendicular. Electric and magnetic field both are perpendicular to each other. Okay, this has 90 degree 90 degree, and with the electric and magnetic field, light moves, it travels in this direction. If we get the vector product, we can say E cross B. Okay, light. But electromagnetic, but in spite of electromagnetic wave, it is not 100% truth. It is light is only an electromagnetic wave, or it is a wave. Okay. So it means when light propagates, it's generally treated as wave. Okay, what is wave? That is electromagnetic. But there are some theories which fail the wave nature of light. Generally, we have learnt about the reflection, diffraction. We have already learned. So these two incidents, reflection and diffraction, which you have already learned, these incidents supports the wave nature of light. Because if light are not waves, if light is not wave, then the reflection, diffraction is not possible. It is not possible to explain the phenomenon of reflection and diffraction without the wave theory of light or the wave nature of light. If we do not consider light as a wave, then reflection and diffraction is not possible. Okay, to explain or to introduce or to understand, it is absolutely impossible to explain reflection or diffraction without the help of wave nature of light. Okay, then again later when we will discuss about interference, okay, all these interference, then we will see that is diffraction. We will see that this also supports the wave nature of light. Based on wave nature of light, that is deflection, diffraction, interference and diffraction, we can easily explain. Without the wave nature of light, these incidents or these phenomena cannot be explained. So these four incidents, deflection, diffraction or interference, purely based on wave nature of light. But this failed wave theory of the wave nature or wave theory of light failed when we discuss about photoelectric equation, that is photoelectric effect, then Compton effect, Newton's corpuscular theory. All these doesn't support wave theory of light. It means when light strikes with any matter, then it is the matter of absorption and emission of radiation. When this comes, then wave theory totally fails to explain these incidents or these phenomena, that is photoelectric effect, compound effect, and Newton's corpuscular theory. According to Newton's corpuscular theory, light consists of particles. Corpuscle, we all know, that is white blood corpuscle, red blood corpuscle, that is very tiny particles. Light is also consist of photon particles, massless photon particles. Because when we will learn about, or when we will discuss about photoelectric effect, we will see that the interchange of energy between photon to energy. When light of suitable frequency will incident on any metal surface, then with that, then the electron on that metal surface, by absorbing the energy from the photon, it will emit. So it is not possible to explain on the basis of this wave theory. In that case, we need to consider light as a particle. So we can say light contains duality, dual nature. Sometimes it behaves as wave, sometimes it behaves as particle, whenever it is necessary. Some incidents or some phenomena, okay, which are possible to explain on the basis of wave theory of light, that is reflection, refraction, interference and diffraction. Whereas some phenomena supports particle nature of light. Because if we don't consider light as a particle, then it is impossible to explain those incidents or phenomena like photoelectric effect, Compton effect, Newton's corpuscular theory. So we may say sometimes light behaves as wave, sometimes it behaves as particle, whenever it is necessary. What is the example? Since each and every time I give examples, is it so that you can remember? Take the example of water, isn't it? When we need to drink water, it is in the liquid form water. Again, if we freeze it, when you need ice for cooling something or to apply it to any wound, isn't it? Or any injury, we need ice, then freeze it is ice. Then again steam, when you need steam, boil that water, it becomes steam. So same things, but three different states. Water in liquid form, ice in solid form, steam in vapor form. So you may assume like this, whenever it is necessary. So light is like that. So we may see that wave, that is light, contains dual nature, isn't it? That is wave, sometimes wave and sometimes particle. Then comes about wave front. New term, wave front. What is wave front? Now simply front. What is front means? Front face, isn't it? Which generally face near. So generally the face of any wave is called wave front in a word. It is not enough. It means a lot. Basically, what do you mean by wave front? The face of any wave, generally we see, whenever any wave is produced, then whatever you see in front, it is called wave front. Clear? Again, we will move to the previous, okay, the previous incident, that is the generation of wave on water, on wastewater bodies by throwing stone. So, suppose this is any water bodies. So, if we throw any stone, what will happen? Waves or ripples are produced and they move in all direction, isn't it? Which is shown here. So generally what happens? This peak wave is formed, which is called crest, and that is the particle with the maximum amplitude. This is called crest, whereas the particles is below the water surface, isn't it? Below the water surface, these are called trough. What is this diagram? Now this diagram is exactly, when this is viewed, this is the representation, that are alternative phase. Alternative shape. It means when this phenomenon is, when it is seen from above, isn't it? Suppose you are at some height or any tree, just beside the bank of a pond, and if you throw a stone and if you see it from vertically, I think it is very clear. This, when this diagram or picture is seen from above vertically, then this picture you will see, isn't it? What are these? The black lines, the black thick lines, these are the crest. So what are the in between the dotted lines, in between, this represents the trough and the particles with minimum velocity. Very easy. If you climb up to a tree, isn't it? Very easy. Just imagine. It is not so difficult to imagine. If you are on the first floor or second floor or any roof, and if there is any water bodies just beside of your house, then if you just throw a stone and just see the entire scenario, what will happen? This picture you will see. And this, the arrow, represents the wave and generally spreading in all directions. So this, when a stone is thrown on this water, what is Krishnakara produced, and it is when you will view from normally above, this scenario you will see. Now in this case, what will happen? As you all know that the particles doesn't move, doesn't progress in direction, it is just ups and downs. So these are the crest in particles with maximum intensity, crest, and the dotted line means this is the hinge or the gap in between the successive crest, the which is represented by the dotted lines. So these are called the wave fronts. Clear? Now in this case, energy will transfer from each particle to each particle. Okay. Now in this case, what would happen? Now if we take any point, suppose we take any point from the center of agitation. Clear? Now suppose this point, assume any point whose displacement is maximum from the point of agitation. So we can draw this line. So we are getting a radius. Now taking this radius, if we complete a circle or draw a circle or sphere, then all the particles on the circumference will also possess maximum displacement. Initially we took one particle with maximum displacement from the center. Now if taking the displacement, taking the distance or displacement of that particle, if we take in the maximum displacement of that particular particle as a radius, and if we draw a circle, then obviously then the particles or the points, water molecules present on the circumference, will also possess maximum displacement, since they are all are on the same circumference. So they are called in same phase. Same phase means, as I already mentioned, when two things are in same situation, two friends are happy, means same phase, two friends are equally happy, equally sad, same. Opposite means one person is happy, one person is crying by watching same movie or same story, isn't it? After reading. So this is phase. Clear? So it means, if taking this at the point O as centra, if we draw so many concentric circles, any concentric circles, then on any concentric circles, on any circles, all the particles on the circumference will be also on same page. On this, on the bigger circle, on the surface, on the circumference or surface of the bigger surface, you can see all particles having maximum displacement, they are having all crest, so they are in same page. Again, if we draw this circle on the circumference of this circle, all the particles are in same page, also crest. Again, on this wall, they are also in same phase. So it means, whenever any wave producing after generating from a source moves or propagates through any vacuum or any other medium, then generally the surface or medium which is generally drawn and upon which if all the particles are in same phase, that particle, that medium, that surface or the line is called wave front. We can say this is one wave front. This is the wave front of the bigger wave. Okay. This is the wave front of the second wave. This is the wave front of the first wave. Very clear? So it means, on a medium, if we draw a medium or any surface or any line, okay, and on the line containing the points, all the points having same page, it means if there are so many several points, if there are several points and if the points are in same page, and then joining that point, if we draw a surface or any plane or any line, it may be straight line or circular, then that plane or surface or the line is called wave front. It means a plane or surface or line contains the points which are in the same page, that plane or line is called wave front. Okay. Now this wave fronts are of two types. Clear? So it means, after originating from a point source, in case of a wastewater body surface, they will spread in the form of a sphere, and on the sphere all the particles will be in same phase and they will be also spherical in shape. Now the wave fronts are of two types. One is plane wave front, one is spherical wave front. Name is, it is very clear. It means a wave front which appears as plane. Okay. This is called plane wave front. Now in this case, it means when the radius of this wave front is very small, then it is called spherical electron. Okay, now you can see from here, its curvature is small, then it is, yes, its curvature is very less. Now if you take a big curve, isn't it? Big curvature, isn't it? You can see if the radius is, means radius is bigger. Now if we take infinite, a huge curve, isn't it? A huge, in that case you can see this portion almost look like a straight line. So if the radius of any wavefront, of a spherical wavefront or any spherical sphere is very more, if the radius of a wavefront is very large, then the small part of the wavefront is generally considered as a plane wavefront. Clear? And if the radius of a wavefront is very small, in that case the curve will be more, in that case it will behave as a spherical wavefront. So basically wavefront we have already learned. So it means, you can see, if some waves are originated from some source, and if we draw any surface, and if the perpendicular drawn on these surfaces generates, okay, are perpendicular. So as you can see, these are the wave fronts, and the perpendicular, the straight lines of the perpendicular drawn on the wave fronts. In this case, if the particles are in same phase, these are called plane wave front. Clear? So we can say that any light or any wave which is generally coming from any infinite, from infinity, then maybe it is as plane wave front, because the radius is huge, it may be considered as a straight line. So in case of a wave front, if we draw perpendicular to the direction of the, okay, if we draw perpendicular, if we draw lines or perpendicular to the plane of the wave front, and in that case if the particles are in same phase, in that case it is considered as plane wave front. It is very clear that the direction of the perpendicular is exactly the direction of the propagation of wave. These are the perpendicular, and it means the velocity of the wave front is same as the velocity of the original wave. What about in case of spherical wave fronts? If any waves generally spread from a point source, then it will spread in all directions, which is generally produced, generally we have seen in case of the wave produced on wastewater bodies. Drop stone moves in all directions, look at what is the shape, sphere. So if any wave is originated or generated from a point, in that case if we draw the perpendicular on the plane of the wave front, then in that case obviously the direction of the perpendicular will also indicate the direction of the propagation of the original wave. But in this case we will get a spherical form. Since why? Because in this case the waves are originated from the point, it is not coming from infinity. In this case we may treat it as a ray, a single, wasn't it, when a parallel rays will come in this case. So when the perpendiculars drawn on the wave front are parallel to each other, they will represent plane wave front. In this case they are not parallel, isn't it? They will, if we extend the backward direction, they move at a point. So any wave front or any wave, if any wave originated from a point source, it will create spherical wave front. Since they move in all direction, they will not parallel, and if we draw any perpendicular on the plane of the wave front, it will be automatically a spherical in form. But in case of any wave coming from a long far distance, finite, it will be, and if we draw the perpendicular, then it will indicate the direction of the propagation of wave, it will be parallel, then they are called plane wave front. Clear? So this is all about wave theory or nature of light and wave front.